In modern society, electricity has become a necessity of life. However, transmitting this power across continents isn't as simple as running a cable. Before Nikola Tesla invented alternating current in 1886, electricity was transmitted using direct current. Due to the rather large resistance to the power lines over long distances, power plants had to be built every few blocks to minimize power loss. Alternating current improves on this problem by using transformers to step up the voltages for long-distance transmission and back down again in cities. However, this presents an entirely new set of problems. While every conductive line has intrinsic resistive properties, alternating current causes another type of impedance, called reactance, that causes further losses in the lines. This is due to the inductive and capacitive properties of the line. Inductors resist change in current, temporarily storing energy in the magnetic field. Capacitors resist change in voltage, temporarily storing energy in the electric field. Together, these can cause phase shifts between the voltage and the current in the line, and can cause an increase in the resistive losses. This is minimized by adding capacitor banks at power substations to adjust the power factor. As you might have noticed, high-voltage power lines often emit a prominent buzzing sound. This buzzing, called corona discharge, is due to the ionization of the air around the power lines. While the air itself is relatively insulative, too large of an electric field can pull the electrons from the atoms, making the air conductive. Due to the potentially substantial power loss, corona discharge is minimized by increasing the diameter of the cables and bundling multiple wires together to increase the surface area. In addition, the voltage of the power lines are generally kept well below 2 million volts. When voltages are above this, the electric field is so large that corona discharge loss surpasses the resistive losses of the lines themselves. Even with these precautions, power loss is unavoidable. Just in the transmission lines, 2-4% of the power is often lost. As Richard Box of Bristol University demonstrated, fluorescent bulbs can actually be illuminated under high-voltage power lines due to power loss. Although the current supplied to the bulb is very small, the voltage difference between the top and the bottom of the bulb is large enough to create a truly breathtaking sight. Thanks for watching.